So this is my 2007 1.6 HDI Peugeot Partner engine, and this is another update of my oil catch can installation. And since I installed the steel scorers and the weather has turned a bit warm, has started to collect oil, so I wanted to slack and dismantle a few parts just to show if oil is coming up and what's going on with the whole system, and what I'm thinking to additionally upgrade this whole system. So first, to have a look at what's inside the old catch can. So if really are interested in how this was done, check out my previous video. So first, to see what's the condition of the old catch can. So first, one thing to notice, so there are several spots here and there from oily bits and pieces, but on the sides, in between where the valve opens, so there is not really no oil parts in there, so which means that this valve hasn't been open. In other words, the pressure hasn't been high enough. I think this is 50 millibars, so it hasn't opened, which is actually quite good, so it hasn't released this. Next is the oil catch can. I mean, so I put the steel scorers inside, and the whole thing is it's fairly oily, so oil comes up to the oil catch can, and if you can see, there is a lot of oily spots around at the bottom where the oil has to coalesce and drop down. So inside, I mean, it's really, really oily. So it kind of, the camera is too bright, but it kind of collects quite a bit of oil. So down in the bottom, there is quite a bit of yellowish and so on fluids. So the next thing is to really, if I put my finger here in the input, so it oil comes up quite a bit. Comes up quite a bit, so I know it has collected oil, so I'm not really sure if the oil that is, I'm not really sure if the oil that has been collected is from the scorers or because the weather became pretty warmer, much warmer now, so it doesn't really condense that much moisture, but it condenses more oil. So I'll put the camera down inside where the exit is, just to show you that there is that much layer of oil there. So just to show that there is a pretty substantial layer of oil above the water. So there is water kind of underneath the hose, or below the below and above, there is a really substantial layer of oil. So it has been collecting oil. So now draining it. Yeah. So I've hidden it. I hidden the hose kind of underneath this plastic and an empty jar. You have to really with that. Cut this before. Lose those, and this is my kind of safety valve. So this is just in order if this is somewhat open, so it wouldn't leak with a bit of a hose inside. So now open it, see what really has been collected. Perhaps move the camera slightly. Well, so let's see. It'll be quite a bit of water, but there will be oil as well. Yeah, there is a slight oil that came down, not too much.
Well, let it drip till it's finished.
So this is really the fluid from the oil catch can. So I'll open this. So I mean, it cannot quite be seen, but that's a really thick oily part. Otherwise, it's very sticky. I mean, the way I see it is extremely sticky. I mean, you can see how it sticks. It doesn't really move. So it has collected, not too bad. Some proportion of oil, and quite a bit of water and a bit of oil that stays on top. So it started to collect oil. So it really collects oil. So this started to move actually. So it has collected oil. So this is really from the bits and pieces from the oil on the side. So it starts to collect oil, but let's see if I've slackened all these tubes. So I just really want to see if how efficient the oil catch can is. I mean, I don't really expect to be 99% efficient, but let's see if really oil travels up and comes up in the turbo. So I've really slackened them all, so it's fairly easy to do so, kind of to save time, not to really film it. So first of all, there is not really there is nothing coming up here, which is quite good. I mean, I don't expect really oil to back down. The next thing is to really look at here. Well, this is the input, so if I put my finger, well, it is quite a bit of oil. It doesn't really separate everything. So yeah, I mean, oil travels. So this is like that. So oil travels, and kind of when hits the border here, kind of condenses additionally. But the other thing is, if I mean, the camera doesn't really show it, but so if one really looks at where the spout comes out, there isn't really much oil accumulated. There is a tiny spot there. So I mean, the oil goes up there. But what is revealing? First, pay no attention to the black spots here. I'll come to that. So this is like that. The oil that hasn't been condensed by the oil catch will come here. So there is a kink. So first we'll hit this band. So if there is really a lot of oil, it will condense there. So if we look just at the kink or inside there, it's really quite clean. Not much really coming on this band. So it doesn't really, it's not that much oil, just slightly. So next, about this circular pattern of oil. So you can see it. I mean, I didn't really notice before installing an oil catch can. So this is quite oily. So what happens is really, my turbo is, it's 95,000 miles so far. So either the seal doesn't really seal that well and lets a bit of oil when it spins, lets a bit of oil and it sprays it in that pattern. From the turbine, or the shaft is also slightly worn, so it slips a bit of oil. So I mean, a way to remedy this is buy a new cartridge and replace it. So I'll probably have to look into that. So I mean, I'm not removing that hose, because there will be some oil around here, and this will probably be full of oil, because it travels from there to the oil catch can, and if I put my finger here, there is quite a bit of oil. So, I mean, the oil catch can is not really 100% removing the oil, despite the steel scores. So I'm not too sure what percentage, what percentage is the efficiency of that. I mean, it's fairly difficult to calculate. But what I'm thinking, it will be an additional update. I've bought really another oil catch can. It's actually pretty small. Oh, it's called KK Mon, but it's fairly cheap. So inside So it's aluminium body. Inside is fairly small. I mean, it's probably more than the hose of this catch can collect. That's the bottom. So at the top, it really has a baffle and some sort of a bronze filter here, which is pretty fine. So the input comes from here, hits this small metal there. So it goes around, probably goes around, coalesces, and then this is the out. So the oil vapor comes from this side and goes out. So it's fairly cheap. So I was what I was thinking. Fitting basically this oil catch can, fitting a second oil catch can here on that side, so the output from this catch can will come in the input of that one, and this will go in the intake. So kind of a second, just to see if this coalesces a bit more, because the gases would have already cooled down, so this might coalesce quite a bit more oil. So I just want to see how much more a second catch can will help. One problem with this is that the spout here is really 6 millimeters, so that's really nothing. So what I have to do is buy some sort of adapter that will fit in here, and it will be whatever 15 or at least 12, 13 millimeters, so it doesn't really not to restrict that much the air. But that will be an additional update. I'll probably do it fairly quickly, within a week or so, and I'll put this update and then drive around, I don't know, 500 miles, just to see, 500 or 800 kilometers, just to see how much this collects. If it starts to correct really quick, I'll do an update quicker. So I mean, that's it. One really advice. So the bottom hose that collects the oil, buy a thicker hose or larger diameter hose than mine, because it's fairly quickly collects, roughly within 500-700 miles. And if the weather is really humid, it collects much quicker. So we have to empty it quite quicker. The steel scorers probably work, but the weather is slightly warm, but the steel scorers probably work. Well, we'll see how well they work. I suspect the original one might be better than this knockoff design, but we'll see with the other oil catch can. So this is for now. Once I install the second oil catch can, I'll do another update if there's any change in the collection of oil. So thank you very much for watching. If you have any suggestions, comments, questions, let me know in the comment section of the video. Subscribe, and thank you very much indeed for watching.